I'm Kristi Curry-Rogers. I'm a professor of biology and geology at McAllister College in St. Paul, Minnesota.
Okay, Kristi, can you tell us about how it was that you got interested in this field to begin with?
I think that my interest in paleontology first began when I was seven. I think a lot of people have this sort of same childhood story. And my interest began because I read an article in a weekly reader magazine in second grade about the discovery of dinosaur eggs and babies in Montana. And I don't think that I realized, I didn't care about dinosaurs before that point, and I don't think I realized that they had babies or did anything that normal animals kind of do. Mm-hmm. And just seeing this image, it was actually the image in the article that made me think that studying fossil animals would be interesting. And so from that point on, anytime anyone asked me, what do you want to be when you grow up? I always said, I want to be a paleontologist. Mm-hmm. And I ended up going to a Girl Scout camp when I was 16 mm-hmm. that happened to be at Egg Mountain in Montana, the same place where these dinosaur baby mm-hmm. discoveries were made. And it sort of solidified my idea that I really did want to study fossils. I was never a dinosaur crazy kind of kid. I just liked fossils mm-hmm. in general. That's where it all began.
But what's so interesting about that for me is that that's some of that research or that interest you've certainly carried into your current research. So maybe you could share something about your current research areas and...
Yeah, so I'm working now on questions that are kind of tied back to that childhood interest. So mm-hmm. I just published a paper about a year ago about a baby long-necked dinosaur from Madagascar from a field area where I work now. So I'm still very interested in that transition between, you know, young and old and growth rates in dinosaurs and in other vertebrates. So that fundamental interest has really carried through mm-hmm. for my entire career.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so during your career, you must have had a number of different mentors. Maybe you'd like to identify a few of them and tell us how they kind of shaped the rest of, you know, the directions that you took in research.
Yeah, when I first started out in college, I went to college in Montana at Montana State University, mm-hmm. and one of my mentors there was Jack Horner. And he was really, you know, I was the only undergraduate student that he had at that time. He had a lot of grad students. I think mm-hmm. at the time I was there in school, I think he had 19 graduate students.
Wow.
But I was the only undergrad. And that gave me some sort of special opportunities to do field work or to work in the museum on research questions. I started off as a fossil preparator. Mm-hmm. And Jack was always very open about letting me try new things, even mm-hmm. things that sometimes might have flopped. Mm-hmm. And I think that his mentorship and just sort of trusting me to ask my own questions and to find out whether I could answer them or not mm-hmm. with the methods I was trying to use mm-hmm. was really inspirational. I also had a lot of really wonderful female mentors during that time of my life because Jack had so many wonderful women graduate students. Mm-hmm. And so they helped me with all kinds of navigation of the early parts of my career, including things like, you know, what do you do when you're in the field? What are sort of field norms? Mm-hmm. How is it to be a female member of an all-male field crew? And those women were very important. So people like Mary Schweitzer, Karen Chin, there were so many. Carrie Ann Sell, who is mm-hmm. a preparator at the Museum of the Rockies, was in the field with me a lot during mm-hmm. those years. And then I went on to graduate school at Stony Brook University, mm-hmm. and I picked that program in part because my advisor was going to be Kathy Forrester. And I thought it was really wonderful to the idea of having a female mentor mm-hmm. after being in this kind of more male-dominated yeah. program was really exciting to me. And it was actually some of those female grad students of Jack's that put me in touch with Kathy and mm-hmm. helped me make that connection. And I had a great time at Stony Brook mm-hmm. being her student. So
great.
Yeah.
How about next if we turn and look at maybe some challenges that you've faced and overcome and, you know,
yeah, I think that, you know, I think that probably the biggest challenge for me was actually, the biggest challenge and one of the biggest blessings was mm-hmm. having my daughter. Mm-hmm. So I have a 15-year-old daughter now, mm-hmm. and when I was pregnant with her, I remember thinking, I am going to just continue doing everything I normally do. I'm not going to let having a child mm-hmm. stop me. And my husband's also in the field, mm-hmm. so we work together, we collaborate a lot on projects, and that meant that I was going to have to take my kid to the mm-hmm. field with me.
Right.
And so starting when she was just 3 months old, we brought mm-hmm. her out with us. And I it was much harder than I thought it would be.
Yeah.
In fact, I think the first 3 years, the last page of every field notebook says, never do this again. And then we did it again the next summer. But having a little tiny person in an environment that's pretty hostile, even to big people, was really challenging. And just kind of the divide in my attention and my focus, which had been sort of solely on the science, especially when I was in the field, and then having to really split my attention between that and between, you know, my daughter, what I thought was really challenging. And I still find it challenging. It's still a challenging kind of path to walk. But it's also really given me, you know, it's been wonderful to have her out with me, and I think it's been really good for her. We'll see what she says as she ages. But, you know, you think about all of the things that children get introduced to when they're in those kinds of faraway, remote environments, no screens, wildlife, campfires, just being outside.
Just a great introduction to it all.
Yeah, it's. I think it's what a lot of kids are missing these days. You know, so many of kids that she knows never go outside at all. And so I think that that's been really, really great. But it has been it's been a challenge in trying to kind of figure out how to navigate. I think there's also some challenge at times that I still face in my career, even now. That I feel like I've really done a lot of work and I have published a lot of papers and I feel good about the work that I've done. I still feel sometimes that there isn't the same level of respect for my work that my male colleagues have for each other's. And sometimes that comes into sharp focus. And when it does, I have to just call people out. And sometimes that can be pretty difficult, as I'm sure you know. So that's another thing that I think has been a little bit hard to navigate at times. Not throughout, but in moments.
But it kind of staying with that a little bit, what kind of advice would you give to somebody that was wanting to enter the field?
Yeah, I think that if I were going to give advice to someone, I think that there are, you know, you really have to know who you are. And you have to be able to stand up for yourself. And that is not always the easiest thing to do, and especially in a field environment. I think that there can be real challenges there at times. So I always encourage people to find mentors that they really trust, that they can really talk to honestly and openly, and to be confident in what they know, and also to realize that they don't know everything.
Right.
And to be open to people giving them suggestions and helping them when they need help. But I think being as confident as possible and making sure that you know who you are and you're willing and able to stand up for yourself is probably one of the most important things that that I've learned over the course of my career.
Great. Well, the last question is really, is there just anything that we haven't discussed that you think you want to add about your experiences in VP?
You know, it's been really wonderful as I've gotten farther along in my career, getting to know other women who are older than me working in the field and sort of sharing the experiences, like having them share their experiences with me and being able to share my experiences with them. It's sort of this nice continuum of mentorship and advice. And everybody does it differently. And I think that that has been a really healthy thing to realize as well, that there's not one particular path for any group of people, that everyone finds their own way. But that having that support network of women both older and younger, you know, now that I'm working with my own students and training my own students, seeing that continuum, I think is really important. So, I appreciate people like you in the field.
Okay, well, thank you very much, Kristi.
Yeah.
That was great.
Thanks, Annalisa.